Hello and welcome. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in collaboration with MAQ Software, we're bringing you this video today about of their amazing custom visual known as the KPI Column visual. So let's head right into Power BI so we can take a look at this. So we're looking here at a visual that looks like a combo chart. We have our columns, we have our lines, but in this custom visual by MAQ Software, the columns actually serve as indicators, and what it's going to indicate is the difference between our measure data and our individual target. And we can set the various parameters of what equals low performance, middle, and high, as you would expect with any sort of KPI type of visual. We can now portray that in this format and this style. Not only that, you might notice just here on the far hand right, we have these three last months that are looking a little more translucent. We also have the capability of adding in and mapping a value here, which is going to show for forecasted data. So this KPI column is great for showing and having indicators for current data as well as forecasted. And we'll see there's some room for some analytics here as well. But before we get into the specifics on how you can get this to work in this fashion, it should be noted that the only two fields that are necessary for this visual to work is category data as well as measure data. That's going to populate our X and Y axis, but we're going to be showing you everything mapped so you can see the full spectrum of what can be done with this custom visual. Now going into the display properties area, we have a lot of really neat features. We have some that you would expect to be there because they're standard as far as X and Y axis, changing the font size, the color, the style, the text. We can do that for both the X and the Y axis. We also have the capability when looking at the target option, and the target is really going to be this dotted line that's listed at the top, and it is mapped to the area called target. So this is going to be kind of an overall target for all of our columns, but what's going to be the item which dictates the indication, right? The green, yellow, the red, and we're going to see we can change those colors, is going to be individual target. But for the overall target, we could turn it on or turn it off, and of course as well increase the stroke width. The same can be done for the individual line as well. So if we wanted to make this a little more pronounced, we can by increasing that stroke width. So I'll leave that here at 2. Continuing, we do find that area where we can do our analytics. In the standard out-of-the-box visuals, normally you'd find that here in the analytics pane, but here being a custom visual, we still have access to it. It's just going to be here in this format area. So if I turn on analytics, we can do whatever we want. We can do an average line, and it's going to place it right there, and we have the choice of specifying the color if we so choose. So you can turn on and off whatever you prefer and indicate the color that is necessary. Now the next piece is going to be zone settings. This is the really important piece. This is how this KPI column comes to life. And what we're talking about is zone 1 and zone 2. And really when we define these two zones, we're actually defining the middle and the high end. So there's actually three here. So what we currently have is 1 through 89.999, 90 through 100, you know, you kind of round it up right before 101, that's the second range, and then a 101 above 101. Basically 101 and above is going to equal green. So we can see that's what we're doing. Low is going to be in that lowest range, which is basically what's left out, what's not been defined here, 1 through 89. Yellow is going to fall in between these two, zone 1 and zone 2. And then high is going to be what represents here and above. So we can see, for instance, if we look, let's say, at this August item, this is around an 86%. So if I dropped this down to 85, we're going to see that this turns to yellow. So that is what is the power here, and that's what's going to dictate how these indicator columns can be most effective. We need to define this as a business. Other items we can have that, of course, you come to expect is we can turn legends on if in case you need that, data labels, and the likes. The last thing that we'll point out is if you did want to take advantage of this forecasting option here, I'll just show this visual here. We do need to have something that is simply a Boolean value. 0 representing its current data, 1 representing that it's forecasted, and that's what's going to give that layer of translucency to those potentially forecasted months. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions about this visual or need a similar business solution, feel free to contact MAQ Software at sales@maqsoftware.com. As well, for any of your Power BI training needs, be sure to reach out to us at Pragmatic Works by emailing us at training@pragmaticworks.com.